Well, there is really only one major story around today. He stepped down from his ministerial portfolio amid serious allegations of sexual harassment yesterday. But are Richard Wirth's days as a Member of Parliament numbered as well? We're joined by political editor Guyon Espiner. Guyon, good morning to you.
Good morning.
This is why people like us live, isn't it, for stories like this? I mean, you know, this is the sort of thing that makes politics very, very interesting. Sadly, there are human beings involved. Richard Wirth, the very latest, what is the very latest that we know?
Well, the allegations keep coming, and it's emerged that Phil Goff approached John Key something over a month ago with claims that a woman connected to the Labor Party was receiving unwanted attention for Richard Wirth, with, it's being reported this morning, in return for some favours, some romantic favours, it's put, that she would possibly be offered some jobs. So that's a very, very serious claim. Now, John Key says that his office has investigated that, that they found that it didn't stand up, and so no action was taken about this. And just to make it clear, that is separate from the incident that the police are investigating.
Do we know that that is separate from the incident the police are investigating?
Absolutely, it is. It is not the incident they are investigating. They are investigating a separate incident which took place a couple of weeks ago. This alleged scenario, I understand, took place around December and was brought to the attention of the Prime Minister between 4 and 6 weeks ago, I think.
All right. And is it alleged that the incident that the police are investigating is of a much more personal nature?
Well, we've been told by about a dozen sources that it is of a sexual nature. We said that last night on the news. I see other papers are reporting that this morning, and certainly no one is denying that.
All right. Is his career as a Member of Parliament over? I mean, the Prime Minister alluded to that. At best, he's going to be sitting right up the back, as far away from everyone in National as they can get him. Is this it for him? Will we ever see him back in the House again?
Oh, look, I think it is it for him. I mean, whether he can struggle on, you've seen it before yourself. We see it with MPs who are faced with criminal charges or have done something which sort of renders them completely useless in Parliament. You can hang on for quite a while as an MP. It is a little bit more difficult to get rid of them. We've seen it happen before. But look, you know, no one's going to want to touch him with a barge pole. He's a List MP. He relies on the party hierarchy's favour for any place at the next election, and that's already gone.
Yeah, and if we just speculate a bit on what he is likely to do, I don't believe he's the sort of person, I mean, he does have some integrity, I don't believe he's the sort of person that will hang on as a backbench Member of Parliament just for the sake of hanging on. I personally suspect he won't be back in the House again ever.
Yeah, although he does have a bit of a sense of entitlement, Richard Wirth, from what I've seen over the years. And it's amazing how some of these people convince themselves that they've done nothing wrong. He may well have done nothing wrong in a criminal sense. These are just allegations.
That is really not the point, though, in this situation, is it?
Well, it isn't the only point, no. And if you look back, it's hardly a stellar career. I mean, he barely got into Parliament when he used an official function in Egypt. He was off riding a camel. He was the
Absolutely.
Subject of ridicule.
I mean, it's just
then.
A litany of disaster for this man. And so it brings me on to my next point. Given that it wasn't a stellar career, before he was appointed a Minister of the Crown, is this a bad look for the Prime Minister? Was this a real mistake elevating him?
Yep, absolutely it was. I mean, where was the judgment there? I'm sorry. I think he was given essentially a favour for his part in helping National secure a larger part of the vote from the Indian community. He did a lot of work around that. Well, fair enough, but it was actually, I mean, it's patronage. I mean, when we went through and did the company searches on Richard Wirth when he went to India for that business trip, it was staggering the amount of actual other jobs that he had at the time. You know, I mean, this is supposed to be a full-time job. You get paid $203,000 to be a minister outside cabinet. You're supposed to be working very hard for the people of New Zealand. I couldn't believe the amount of other work that he was actually doing. And I just don't think that John Key displayed the judgment in appointing him in the first place and not getting rid of him at the time that fiasco developed with the India trip.
We're going to talk to Phil Goff in just a moment, but still on John Key. We made repeated calls to have him on the programme this morning. I know there are many other outlets of media that want to talk to him in more detail about this. Given that we are talking about a fully funded by the taxpayer Minister of the Crown, isn't it entirely appropriate that the Prime Minister come clean with the country and give us more details than he has?
Absolutely. He's got a front up. He's the chair of the cabinet. He is the sole responsibility for ministers. And I tell you, one person who does end up looking pretty good out of this, and it is Phil Goff. He did the right thing. He didn't make political capital out of those allegations. He went to John Key with them on the private, and they've only just come out now. So if there's anyone who's coming out looking good out of this pretty sorry saga, it is Phil Goff.
All right, very, very quickly, Cam Calder. Do we know much about Cam Calder?
No, except that he might be getting ready to come back into Parliament, as you intimate. He's the next on the party list and would come in. He's a dentist, I understand, Cam Calder, and he would be next in on the party list should Richard Wirth fall on his sword.
All right. I'd certainly be packing an overnight bag if I was him. Guyon, thank you very much for joining
us.
And a toothbrush, yes. Thank you very much,
Guyon. Never goes anywhere with that one.
Sharp as a tack, Guyon Esterman.